Where is 7? This is kind of a silly question because we usually speak about how 7 works. We have 7 of something, 7 chairs, 7 days of the week, whatever. But where is 7 itself? What is 7? Well, obviously it's a number, living with all the rest of them. Numbers are ideas in that there's nowhere in the world we could physically go and find 7 and poke it with a stick. Ideas live in our minds. Each of the 7.5 billion people, despite having very different personalities, histories, hopes, tragedies, everything, despite all the differences in how those minds are organized, if they can understand counting and can get to 7, then we can all come to an agreement on what 7 is and how it works. I think that's incredible. The benefit of coming at something as simple as the idea of 7 in this way is that it gives us the freedom to create new ideas, new numbers, new number-ish things, and so on. These collections of numbers are called sets, and we're going to explore 5 sets in particular right now using this. Let's get started. The first collection of numbers is the one that you learned when you learned how to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. It's a natural starting point. In fact, it's so natural that's what they're called, the natural numbers, which we'll represent by this n thing here. Let me pause here and throw out a few terms. We're going to call collections of numbers a set. We will call the things in the set elements, which in this case are numbers. And that little thing here is called an ellipsis. Basically, it means just follow that pattern out to infinity. So that's the natural numbers. Let's extend this. If I teach you how to do something, counting in this case, then I need to show you how to reverse it as well. With the natural numbers, that means counting downwards. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then what? 0? Yes, so into the next set it goes. But can we count farther in that direction than 0? Well, the answer is yes. We just begin counting what are called negative numbers, and they look like this. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, so on. There are some pretty easy to see uses for these. Negative amounts of money can be used to represent a debt to someone, while negative numbers in a directional sense can mean distance traveled in the opposite direction, to name a few. We can count down to negative infinity, so when we write the set out, it will look like this. This is what we'll call the integers, but curiously enough, we label it with a Z, in this case for the German word Zahlen, or as I'm to understand it, numbers. So, let's actually measure something. Oh, now wait, this measurement didn't land on a whole number of inches. To go smaller, we will need to slice up the inch into smaller pieces, that is, fractions of an inch. How small we need the slices to go will determine what kind of fractions we use. If we need halves, we make the cut here. If we need quarters, that is, cutting the inch into 4 equal pieces, we will cut in these 3 places. Now, the actual thing we're measuring is actually out to here, so we will need a system that keeps track of 2 things, the sizes of the slices and how many of those slices we are considering. We arrange them into fractions like so. The bottom tells us how big our slices are, which we will call our denominator. And the top tells us how many of those slices we're dealing with, which we will call our numerator. When you're dealing with a ruler in inches, you generally are dealing with halves or quarters or eighths or sixteenths or whatever. When you're dealing in centimeters, you're generally dealing with tenths, called millimeters. This is our next system of numbers. There's a few names we have for them, fractions, rationals, or quotients, and in fact the last name is what we'll use to label the set, Q. So how can we write a set definition for this? Well, it turns out that it's a bit more involved than the previous ones. Here it is. So now we can measure anything, right? Well, not necessarily. Let's take a look at this thing here and measure it. In fact, it's a right triangle, and the 2 shorter sides both have a length of exactly 1 foot. Or at least we can imagine they're exact. But here's what's really interesting. Even if you imagine a perfect ruler, and a perfect artist, which I'm not, the length of this side will never land on a tick mark, not perfectly. As it turns out, we need a new kind of number here, and that's called an irrational. Here's what it looks like. As it turns out, we can convert all the numbers we've seen before into decimals. Sometimes this looks like zeros that go on forever, like this one here. Usually we only write the first decimal because it would be kind of useless to write out all of them, and not to mention impossible. Other times, as with all rational numbers, it looks like a sequence of repeating numbers. Here's a couple on the screen here. What's really special about the number we just came up with is that this sequence never repeats. For that reason, we call it an irrational number, not to say that it's somehow crazy, although it can seem like that, but rather to contrast it with the rational numbers, which all repeat. It would be impossible to write this number out in its entirety even once, much less every time we needed a measurement like this. What's worse is that if we clip off the end, that is to say truncate it, we lose all the decimals that follow. There is a simpler way to write this though, and here it is. It's the square root of 2. This is also perfectly accurate. We'll see later in the series why this number is a square root of 2, but for right now just trust me. This is a new thing. We call it an algebraic number.
If you like the definition of the quotients, you're gonna love the definition of the algebraic numbers. A simple way of looking at it, though, is that the set of algebraic numbers is made out of every single combination of integers and square roots and addition and subtraction and multiplication and division and exponentiation possible. And as you've probably guessed, that's a lot. But there are still more numbers. It turns out there's another type of decimal, which comes from arguably an even simpler shape, the circle. This circle has a diameter of 1 foot. That is, it's 1 foot across. Its circumference, which is the distance around the circle itself, is a very special number. In fact, it's so special, it gets its own name, pi. There are a lot of reasons that the circle is such an important shape, but the one I like best relates to the fact that as geometric shapes go, it's as pure as you can get. Anyway, the thing about pi is that it cannot be written as a combination of square roots or any roots whatsoever. Yes, it's irrational, and yes, that means the decimal version of pi, this, goes on forever, but that doesn't mean that you can combine things like root 2 into being pi. That puts it in its own class of numbers called transcendentals. The set definition is more or less a contrast with the algebraic numbers. That is, if it's not algebraic, it's transcendental. Now, if you've been paying very close attention, you can tell that there's a problem here. And this is where I have to put the ruler down and have a heart-to-heart with you.
You see, there's this other kind of number that we've included in this explanation, but didn't really talk much about. And it's going to push the boundaries of what we mean by number. That thing is the square root of -1. But we're going to have to save that for the next video, where we'll learn about the real numbers and the imaginary numbers. In this video, we've learned about the natural numbers, the integers, the quotients, the algebraic, and the transcendental numbers. We're going to have one more video learning about 3 more kinds of numbers, and then we're going to move into actually doing things with those numbers. Thanks to Origami for hosting this episode of the Taylor Series, and congratulations to you on successfully completing the next term in your own Taylor expansion. I'm Derrick Taylor, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe. If you really like the video, come on over to our Patreon page where you can get involved and see all the cool stuff we're doing.